A very cheerful good morning to all of you. Hoping for your good health and safety at home. Today we will be revising the poem I Cannot Remember My Mother by the famous poet Rabindranath Tagore. So before I start explaining the poem, let's first of all read the poem. I cannot remember my mother, only sometime in the midst of my play, a tune seems to hover over my playthings, the tune of some song that she used to hum while rocking my cradle. I cannot remember my mother, but when in the early autumn morning, the smell of shuli flowers floats in the air, the scent of the morning service in the temple comes to me as the scent of my mother. I cannot remember my mother, only when from my bedroom window I send my eyes into the blue of the distant sky, I feel that the stillness of my mother's gaze on my face has spread all over the sky. So this is a very emotional poem by the poet Rabindranath Tagore. It's about a child who has lost his mother at a very tender age, and the child misses her every moment. He remembers her and feels her presence everywhere, yet he repeats, I cannot remember my mother. The child repeats this line again and again, probably because he cannot remember how she looked and has just a faint recollection. It means the child was too young when he lost his mother, so now he does not remember the exact face of her mother, but he has faint memories. He remembers her mother through various things present around him. So now let's start the explanation part. So here I am going to explain you the first stanza. The first stanza says, a child who lost his mother in infancy has only faint recollection. He can just remember her mother by various things present around him. The poet states that he cannot remember his mother now. However, he feels her presence into his life when he is in the middle of his play with his playthings. He senses a tune hovering over him. It is the tune of his mother's song, which she used to hum while rocking his cradle. It means, while playing with his playthings, the noise of the toys make him remember a tune which her mother used to hum. Means a tune of a song which her mother used to sing while rocking his cradle. Now next, moving on to stanza number 2. In this stanza, the poet explains, when it is early autumn morning, the smell of the shuli flowers floats in the air. Then the scent of these flowers again makes him remember his mother. The poet smells the scent of the morning service in the temple. In that smell, he senses the scent of his mother, as his mother used to take the same flowers for the morning service to the temple. So in the second stanza, the poet is remembering her mother through the smell of shuli flowers, which are often used in the morning prayer service in the temple. So by the smell of these flowers, he remembers his mother, that these are the same flowers which her mother used to take to the temple for the morning service. Now the next stanza says, when the poet is in his bedroom, he looks out into the blue of the distant sky through his window. He feels the silent, steady and protective look of his mother being cast down at him from her heavenly abode. Her face seems to be spread all over the sky. It means, while standing alone in his bedroom window, when he sees up in the sky, he can feel the steady and protective gaze of his mother. He can see the face, the faint face of his mother, as if she is seeing his son from the sky and showering her blessings on him. So by reading this poem, we come to know that the poet was really a very small child, or was at a very young age when he lost his mother. He cannot remember his mother's face exactly, but he remembers his mother through various things present around him. Firstly, he remembers his mother through the sound of the toys while playing with his playthings. Secondly, the smell of the shuli flowers in the autumn season again reminds him of his mother, as she used to take the same flowers to the temple for the morning prayer service. And lastly, while standing in the bedroom window, when he sees up in the sky, he can feel the gaze. He can feel that his mother's face is spread all over the sky and is looking upon his son and showering her blessings. So this was the explanation of this poem. So I hope you must have understood the poem. It's a very simple and an emotional poem which explains how a small child is remembering her mother after losing her at a very young age. So now, after this explanation, I expect all of you to once again go through the poem and read it, and then just try to understand, and then again recollect what all I have explained in this poem. So after this, again we'll meet on Monday and we will be discussing the question answers part of this poem. So till then, keep safe at your place and do revise your lessons regularly. Thank you and have a good day.